All right, we would like to invite Kaino Africa to come and present.
Hello, everyone. Linda Kinaras is my name. I'm a co-founder and the Chief Curriculum Development Officer at Kaino Africa. The boy you see on the screen is called Timothy. Timothy is a son to my border guy. So this man saw how the children as homeschooling could read and write at a very tender age. And he was so intrigued. And desperately, he asked me to take on his son. Now, on meeting Timothy, even after being in school for 3 years, he was as good as a child that had never been to school. After 1 month of enrolling, Timothy could not only read and write well, but he's aspiring to be an astronaut because he found his new love for science. Now, just like Timothy, we see very many children who are in school, but they are not learning. When we check the UESO report, we see that about 80% of primary school going children can't do basic mathematics, and 60% cannot read English basic sentences. 7 million children, according to the UBOS report, fail to transition to secondary school, meaning only 10% progress to university. Now, according to Kaino, we trace all these learning problems to lack of early mental stimulation, and that is the problem we are here to solve. Right now, because of COVID, we are all aware that nursery schools are as good as written off, at least as per the Minister of Education. So we have about 1 million parents that are stranded with their nursery school going children at home because of COVID. Now, Kaino is a tried and tested product that we've witnessed enable a child to read and write in just 1 month. As part of our solution, we have a STEM blended curriculum. Under this, you find very easy to use and quality lesson guides that are, of course, STEM infused. And we use the phonics approach of teaching because we understand that literacy is the foundation of all learning. Then we have web and mobile applications. For our STEM, we have a kit that these children can use to do their STEM experiments. And then we have workbooks for these children to do their graphomotor skills. We understand the knowledge gap among very many teachers and now parents who are new at this. And we have curated teacher training tutorials and online workshops to cut down the risk of contracting COVID-19. And then the report that I used, the UESO report, is of 2015. That shows you how much of a big data gap we have in early learning. So we have partnered with Save the Children and we are using their IDELA tool to collect as much data as we can. As I speak now, we have developed and launched our web application, and that is the URL in case you want to check it out. These are some of the learning areas. There are 5 in number. By the time we launched our product at the Ministry of ICT, that was on the 24th of September last year, we were at 30% of our content development. As I speak right now, we are at 90%. And this content runs a child through 3 years of their nursery school education. We are going after a market that is that big. We are looking at Africa, and we are considering nursery, primary, and secondary schools that is valued at about 20 billion. Later on, we intend to scale to nursery and primary schools in sub-Saharan Africa, and it's valued at 8 billion. Our primary market is Uganda, and the valuation is at 29 million annually. That is our business, this is our business model is. In our B2C, we charge about 38,000 per week, 110,000 per month, and 800,000 per year. Then in our B2B, we charge about 100,000 per child per term. Then our workbooks go for that much, and these take a child through the whole term. This is the traction we've managed to get. In our B2C, we have about 156. Of course, that is when we submitted because of the minister's announcement. We are getting more numbers. Wow. Okay, then in our B2B, we have three schools. Then we have our homeschooling model that has about 20 children that are already paying. But if we decided to monetize our online platform, we should be able to collect 287 million across 12 months. This is how our competitive landscape looks like. We've zeroed down on Bridge. Bridge has to build schools, we don't have to. And then our phonics and STEM approaches not only get the children's minds stimulated, but they get to read and write within the shortest period. We are asking for 50,000 for a 10% stake in our company. It should be able to help us acquire about 100 schools. Within 12 months, we shall have about 10,000 students. We intend to complete our Kano offline mobile application. Already, we are doing trainings in villages. We're training women to help to be a part of their children's education. So we intend to train about 300 women, and the rest of the money will go into operations. We have managed to get a partnership from the Ministry of ICT. We intend to leverage on that partnership to get Kano whitelisted, then get approvals from NCDC and Ministry of Education. Our projections show that by the fourth quarter, we should be able to make about $150,000. This is our team, the co-founding team. At the helm, you see Alfredo Pio, he's the CEO and a co-founder. Myself, a K-12 curriculum development specialist. Cedric is an educationist, also under the content department. And Matthew Watcher is our CTO. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let's have some questions from the judges.
Thank you so much. I'd be interested in some of those workbooks. My only question is around the valuation. It's very ambitious. So if you could walk us through that a little bit, it would be helpful.
Like I mentioned, in our term, the total addressable market, we are looking at nursery, primary, and secondary schools in Africa. That is our term, eventually. I know some companies never get to hit it, but there is no crime being ambitious. Yeah, and then, of course, the reasonable market is sub-Saharan Africa, because as I speak right now, there are very many countries that are yearning for our product. For example, we're getting calls from East African countries that really want, and it just shows me that any country in sub-Saharan Africa needs this product. And then, of course, the $29 million, that is addressing the valuation for the nursery schools. We have about 850,000 as per UBOS, school-going nursery children. So that is how we came about the market opportunity. And you can notice that it's annually. It's an annual evaluation.
If I buy a workbook as a school, what is the incentive for me to come and renew? Because it's physical. That's my assumption, that it's a physical workbook. And then I use it as, and so yeah, and I think tied into that, What do you mean by school acquisition?
Like I mentioned already, we have about 3 schools that, you know, because of COVID, schools were caught unaware. So there are not very many schools that have curated content that they can readily put into a system. And even if they have it, they don't have confidence in their content. Very many schools are actually gamblers. Yeah, so we have been in a position where we have taken time and put in the expertise to curate the right content. So that's why most of these schools, for example, our content is STEM infused. By STEM, I mean science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And this is primarily to stimulate the child's brain. And then, like the phonics approach, there are not very many schools that use it. They still do the ABCs. And you find children getting even more confused. So every time they get to know our product, they definitely want to use it.
Thank you. We have one question from Joanna, and then we'll move on to the next team.
Thank you. Great presentation. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you.
I have one question. If you could expand upon the claim that you teach children to read and write within 1 month, or that they will learn. So what kind of metrics are you using to make that claim? I think that's a really great selling point if the data supports it.
Okay, when I say that children learn how to read and write in 1 month, what I mean is what the results we have seen. For example, Timothy is a slum boy. Actually, this is a product that we looked at, people looked at like it's a high-end product. We're like, why don't we try this with a kid that would be from, let's say, a slum, so that we see the effect. And within just 1 month, this boy could read and write, because with phonics, the phonics approach, we look at sounds, not the letters. So as fast as you can go through the sounds in a fun way, this kid is also indirectly learning how to read. I hope I've answered your question.
Yes, you have. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Kaino Africa. A round of applause for her.
Thank you for listening.
All right. We